It's September 29th, around, I want to say, 6 o'clock, and I'm in my room. We're leaving for the airport in about 20 minutes, so that I can pick up my best friend of 4 years for the first time. I've never met her in person. We FaceTimed all growing up for me. This is hard to hold upside down. We've spent like 90% of our growing up time together. Growing up time, is that a thing? It is now. She got me from point A to point B. She got me through a really dark time in my life, and I helped her through hers, and we're still best friends to this day. That was 4 years ago, and this is now. And overall, I'm just really ready for this to finally be happening.
Air Canada? Where's Air Canada? Oh, lit. Nice.
Look at that. That's a creature in its natural habitat. That? See the bags?
Yeah, I zoomed in on them.
That's the joys of planning a sweet 16 and working and not sleeping and all the other crap I do.
In case you couldn't tell, waiting at the airport was the longest hour of my entire life.
Look, everybody, it's my toddler.
Which one?
Right there, it's my toddler.
Oh, we've waited for you so long. It's been like an hour. Oh, it's so nice to finally see you. Oh, look at that haircut. You know, you look a little different, but that's all right. Maybe
yeah,
like
shines under the light.
Yeah, it's kind of glimmery a little.
Casey, you put on weight and lost your hair. It's like a bad Criminal Minds episode.
You should talk.
You know, it took you long enough.
I don't know what I'm supposed to do with this. Come on, don't be an idiot.
Hi.
How you doing?
Jason.
Nice to meet you. I didn't have time to stop to get any food or anything because I had like 10 minutes till my flight left by the time I got there, so didn't have time for my Timmy Hortons.
The rest of that night was mostly just getting her settled in and getting used to each other and kind of just taking a step back and realizing that, wow, you exist. But what's more important is what I recorded the next day, which was...
That's
great.
Hi everyone, I guess I'm getting this party started with some speeches, so I'll just start with a quick introduction. My name is Casey, and for those of you who don't know, I'm from a small town in Alberta, Canada, and I have flown here especially for this event. It took me 5 hours, but it was worth it to finally meet my best friend. We met when you were 12 and I was 15. Now you're 16 and I'm 19, and I cannot believe how fast the time has gone. Watching you grow has been an honor. You have been my best friend for many years and have always been there for me unconditionally. You have stuck by me through my lows, and whenever I have a great day, you're the first one I want to tell. I cannot tell you how many moments I've experienced from 3,000 miles away that I wish you were there to experience with me. You have taught me so much about acceptance, friendship, dedication, passion, and just life. I am so proud to have been a part of your life for the past 4 years, and I can only hope that you see the potential in yourself that I see in you. There was a time in my life when I had such bad anxiety I couldn't even answer the phone. And yet here I am, standing in another country, surrounded by people I barely know. You have broken me out of my shell in so many ways and inspired me even more. I don't fly cross country for just anyone. It's a good life, and I wouldn't change this moment for the world. Tori, I hope this night is everything you've ever hoped for, and I'm so unbelievably happy to be here to share it with you. Cheers.
The next day was tons of fun. I had a football game and a competition, both of which you decided to drag yourself to, even though you really didn't have to. You went to both shows, and you were there to support me, and you said that you wanted to see what made me passionate, and you knew it was this. So you were there for every count, even if it was freezing and the hot chocolate wasn't that great. Since there's no marching bands up in Alberta, apparently, I was honored to be your first experience. It was really nice to have you there. While Sunday was meant to be our free day, we just kind of spent it playing my guitar and sitting in my room doing absolutely nothing. And my mom got you Dunkin' Donuts coffee because apparently she thinks it was better than Tim Hortons, but you have to disagree because that's your favorite coffee place. I wasn't sure if you were playing Taylor Swift to make fun of me because of how much I like her, or if it was the only song you knew.
There's some chords all strung together in one big progression.
Incredible. Truly impressive.
I do what I can.
How's that treating you?
We then went out to dinner, where apparently Houlihan's has some great vegetarian options.
Does something. Dude, I wouldn't either. I'd get away from you as soon as I could.
I'm so excited to get up there.
Her iced tea is just sweet tea in Canada.
It comes in like powder in a big thing that says iced tea. You like put it in your water and mix it up, and it's like really sweet.
I used to make that all the time.
But of course, 1 a.m. brought a different kind of adventure.
Finish my hot chocolate.
Oh, you finished your hot chocolate?
Hold on.
Hold on.
I have to pee.
Making this bitch some peanut butter toast at, like, what time is it? Oh, great. Perfect. Perfect. She went to pee. Doesn't like Dunkin' Donuts that much. I don't know how. Is that her? Is that what that was? It was.
What? It's just me. I'm going to get my peanut butter toast. Because that's what we do in the morning in Jersey, apparently. Nobody sleeps in America.
Nobody ever sleeps.
Toast it is. I'm exhausted, but I'm still awake. This toast is gonna keep me going until I have to get on my plane at 8 in the fucking morning.
So flip it.
Tori asked me if I was gonna use a knife to spread my peanut butter. Like, I don't know what else I would use to spread my butter, but I suppose this knife will do. She even cleaned the bread off of it, even though I'm going to spread it on more bread right now.
That's what we do in America. We eat at ungodly hours, and then we eat too much. Welcome. You don't get any.
And while 2 a.m., 1 a.m., whatever, was a pretty fun adventure, all good things must come to an end.
Oh, good. It's like 4 a.m. and I'm exhausted, but I'm really dizzy. It's time to go.
But it's time to go. Even her, she just want you to go. Fucking Chihuahua's like, what are you doing? You heard me?
No, I want salad. So we're getting salad, right?
Good job, Herschel. Now, get in.
It is pretty horrible.
$2.15.
It's gonna take forever because they're gonna like shoot me away.
Who?
The Port Authority doesn't like giving it out.
And this was the hardest part because suddenly those 3,000 or some odd miles between us were back and my best friend wasn't next to me anymore. And the seat next to me was empty and I didn't want it to be, but I'll miss you. Until next time, Canada. Gonna stop by drinking old cheap bottles of wine, sit talking up all night, saying things we haven't for a while, yeah. We're smiling but we're close to tears, even after all these years, we just now got the feeling that we're meeting for the first time.